Welcome, 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 ladies and ladies, all of you, so great to see you, to be with you here today on this amazing Friday. And I can see we have ladies from all over the world. We have London, Keely, welcome. We have Gothenburg, UK, but currently in Turkey. Sarish, I see you. We have Nottingham, Nairobi, Leeds, Australia, Columbus, Ohio, welcome, Birmingham. It's absolutely fantastic to be here with all of you beautiful ladies today. And, this is just crazy. Now, I'm going to do something different today. I'm going to allow people or any of you ladies to start your videos if you want to. This is just an option, by the way, because I got some feedback last time that, you know, it's nice to see everyone. I can see a few. Alida, I see you. They're right there. So good to see you. But now, sometimes it's good, feel more connected when we can see each other face to face. So it's just something that I'm trialing out a little different this time. And I know some of you might be thinking, no, I don't want anyone to see me, which is fair enough. No problem. But I just want to say a massive warm welcome to each and every single one of you. Again, my name is Mandeep. I'm your host for today. And I'm so proud of, our team. I'm so proud of, each and every single one of you, because I remember when I started this business, when I started this platform about 4 years ago, and I didn't see any women. I didn't see the ladies. I didn't see any girlfriends. And I was thinking, you know what, making money and growing together sounds great, but where are the women? I honestly, if my mentor heard this, he wouldn't be impressed, but I didn't feel that inspired. I didn't feel that inspired, not because of him, but because of the fact that I wanted to see women like me. I wanted to see women that were women, that were from different backgrounds, religions, cultures, countries, women that where we could really unite ourselves together. And there's so many people on this call. I can see if I have a look at the list of all you amazing women, there's such a range of beautiful, amazing individuals here. So again, if this is your first time here or you're a guest on this call, I just want to say a massive warm welcome. Now, today I wanted to really shake things up. I wanted to shake things up because I like to do that once in a while. Over the last few times we've had our Women Empowerment Call, we've actually interviewed a few of the ladies, and they've come on, they've shared their testimonial. And what I wanted to do today was actually something a bit different, because what day is it today? Today's the 22nd of October. So this is our last empowerment call for the month. Okay, because obviously every month, every other week. And I thought, let me do something to do with a certain topic, which I feel I lacked a lot of in the beginning days. Okay. And we are going to be looking at the word. It begins with F for Freddie. It's not Freddie. We're not focusing on Freddie. But can anyone guess what that word is? What we're going to be doing today? Put in the chat box. Can you guess what we're going to be looking at today? Faith, focus, future. Oh, I love these words. I love it, love it, love it. Family. Ooh, okay. Well, Alida, you got it right there, darling. Well done. So we're going to be looking at the word focus, because this is something that personally I feel from experience has helped me a lot. And I wanted to just have a chat with all of you, a conversation, friendship. That's an amazing one as well. Actually, friendship will come into it. All these things that the rest of you have mentioned, they do actually come into it. But today I said to you in the WhatsApp group, I said, look, get together your notebooks, your pens, and also your diaries as well. Okay. So we're going to go through a selection of exercises here and questions as well, a bit of a Q&A. But I want you to really engage with this and interact with this, because when I did this, it was so interesting and it really opened my eyes up to, okay, I've got some serious work to do. So we're gonna do this together. But at the top of your paper, I want you to write down your goal that you set for this year, because, and maybe, I don't know if you have set a goal, most of us do, but at some point in the year, probably at the beginning of the year, you will have had a focus. Now, your focus is going to be in various areas, but the three main ones, okay, the three main ones are what, goals in terms of what people like to focus on, if I just put it here, is health, money, relationships, and family. Okay, maybe adventure. Although adventure, if you're looking to travel and do that sort of thing, I think that probably would have gone out the window this year because of all the craziness going on in the world out there. We're not going to mention that. We're just going to say the P word. But what was your goal this year in relation to health, money, relationships, family, or adventure? Something that you set for yourself. This is obviously going to be a personal goal. Maybe you're in a, you know, you're in a company right now and you're looking to hit a certain rank or get to a certain money goal. Maybe health wise, you made a commitment that, you know, I'm going to lose a certain amount of weight. I want to challenge myself by eating certain foods. Maybe it was adventure. You want to, you know what, adventure. Actually, I'm going to put here adventure and comfort zones because this is actually a good one. How many of us made a commitment to ourselves that we were going to come out of our comfort zones this year, this month? You know, something that you have to have a goal basically for this exercise, something that you're going to focus on in this 2021 year, right? So once you've written that down, I want you to now look at your diary. And if I look at the date, okay, this is interesting actually. From Monday, the 18th of this month, Monday, the 18th of October, I want you to write down what you have done every day between just this Monday and today towards your goal. Just write down one or two things that you've done. And by the way, no one's going to see this paper. This is just to get you thinking about some things which we're going to discuss. So you've written down your goal for the year. Now, something that you've done towards that goal. Now, some of you will have one step or one thing. Some people will have two things, three things. Some people have nothing to write. You will have nothing to write because it's to do with the F word, which we discussed, which was a focus. So you've got your goal, but then what were the activities that you personally did this week in relation to that goal? Okay. Now what I want you to do is I want you to rate yourself on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being I've done really poor and I've not done anything, and 10 being, you know, I got this, like I did what I set out to do and that's it. Then I want you to all come out of your comfort zone and put that number in the chat box, because look, it's a safe space here. It's all good. And by the way, even though the call was recorded, no one can see what's on the chat box anyway. Okay. So they're not going to know your names or anything like that. It's just to give other, you know, ladies on this call an idea of where we all are. And look, don't be shy. Don't be shy. Let's just have an open conversation. So in relation to that goal, we've got sixes, we've got fives. Okay, yep, that's absolutely fine. We've got a three, we've got a six, we've got a seven. Okay, so we've got one. Okay, so okay, I can see loads of different numbers. Okay, what I want you to write down now underneath that is where was your focus this week? Where was your focus this week? In relation to that particular goal, where was the focus and why were you unfocused? Because we're trying to work backwards here and find out the root of why the actions were not taken. And if they were taken and you rate yourself high, give yourself a pat on the back, my friends, because you've done great. But for those of you that didn't achieve the goal, like say if it was health and you've not managed to go to the gym or eat well or whatever it is, or something to do with, say, money, and you're supposed to be engaging in something towards helping you to do that, why wasn't it done? Where was the focus this week? Now, the reason for getting you to do this exercise is because if you compound this activity over the last 10 months, some of you and some of us can be in quite a shock, because what you'll find is that you set a certain goal at the beginning of the year, but what's happened is that maybe you started off here, right? You started off here. So this is where you are, okay? You are at point A and you want to get to point B right here. So you're thinking, you know what? This is my year. This is 2021, and this is exactly where I'm going. And what tends to happen with a lot of people is they start here, they're motivated, they're going, and something happens and locks them back. So they start doing this. Then they get back on track and say, yeah, I'm going to do it. Okay, yeah, I'm going to get back here. Then something happens again. Then something even worse happens. Then something even worse happens, and then they're slightly back up. But then it doesn't quite go to plan, and then they give up, and they end up somewhere down here. This was me a few years ago, by the way. I had no focus. I'd start off every year thinking, do you know what? This is going to be my year. I'm going to do amazing. I'm going to do great. But year after year, I was getting the same results. I was getting the same results. And I was thinking to myself, something has to change. So if you have a look at the last 10 months of your activity, obviously it's quite a big task, so you might have to do some of this after the call, but have a look at how close you are to your goal percentage wise. Are you 75% of the way there? Have you already done it? Are you 10% of the way there? Rate yourself percentage-wise. How close are you to your goal? Because look, there's only 2 months left of the year. So how close are you towards achieving that? Again, this will give you a real idea of where the focus really is. Where is your focus? Now, unfortunately, we have what's called the D word. The D word is distractions. Distractions are very, very good at taking away focus. Very, very good. Some of you might call it devil. Some of you might call it distractions, whatever it is you want to call it. But these things are going to distract you. Now, you might want to write this down. Most distractions will come in the form of people. Most distractions come in the form of people. So now what I want you to write is, guess what? I want you to write down the 5 people who you hang around with. Write down on the piece of paper, who are the 5 people that you are around or that you speak to on a daily basis? Seriously, write it down. This exercise is mind-blowing, trust me. When you look back and reflect, it'll be like, oh, wow. It's really to help you gain some insights into your own personal behaviors and how you do things. So even if you don't meet people at the moment or you're sort of busy or whatever it is, who do you talk to the most? In fact, if you go on your favorites list right now, and I'm going to do the same, who's on your favorites list? Who are you constantly talking to on a daily basis? Do they lower your energy? Do they increase your energy? Do they fill you with positive vibes or do they not? After you've come on off the phone to that particular friend, how is it that you're feeling? How is it that you're feeling? I remember this once ex-friend, who's no longer a friend, unfortunately, and I had to distance myself. All she spoke about was negativity. That was it. That was all that came out of her mouth. And I remember thinking, I know when I speak to her, I'm not going to feel uplifted. I'm not going to feel positive or empowered, inspired. I'm going to feel low. And I started noticing that, because the more that I engaged with the people that really uplifted me, the more I started to notice, hang on, this person isn't serving my energy. My number one thing to you on this call is please, please protect your energy. That's the main thing. We have to be protective because, yeah, a leader, I totally understand. I mean, had to get away from these people, these friends, because they don't understand you. They do not understand it. And protecting our energy, ladies, I'm telling you right now, it will make you or break you. It is so important that you're in a position where you're protecting your energy, because the people around you, they should uplift you and inspire you and empower you and stretch you to be your best self. So remember, going back to what I was saying, distractions come in the form of people. How distracted were you this year? Or were you fully focused? Now, it doesn't mean, I'm not saying that every minute of the day, 24/7, we're like robots and we stay focused. Of course, we attend to other things, and we have a life to run as well as doing our goals. We've got to get on with family and life and all the rest of it. So your environment and the people in that environment are going to be the biggest distractions. Now, I'm going to show you how to help you correct all this, but your environment, what does that look like? Write it down on your paper. If I walked into your bedroom right now, or I said to you, right, ladies, turn your videos on and just show me around your house and show me around your, some people have switched their videos off now. But don't worry, I'm not going to ask you to do that. I won't ask you to do that, but I'm just saying rhetorically. If I said to you, right, Kiran or Kulani or Nazia, put your video on and can you give us a tour of your house? It's not that I want to see if your house is tidy or not. That's not the aim of the game. The aim of that exercise is, are your goals in front of you? If I was to look at your environment right now, is it conducive to your goal? The goal that you set this year, would I see pictures and images around your home of it? Shall I tell you how crazy I am? If I'm looking at my desk right now, I've got my goal there, I've got it there, it's on my laptop. If you went in my bathroom right now, my goal is right there. Because guess what? When I'm brushing my teeth and washing my face in the morning, I'm not just looking at the window or outside, I'm looking at my goal. It doesn't matter what distractions are around me. The first thing I'm doing when I get up is seeing that goal. I am seeing where I want to be. So my question to you is, if you have, your goals, if they're written down, are they sitting on a shelf gathering dust, because you set a goal 6 months ago, 12 months ago, 18 months ago, whenever it was, but you're still not there. And you're thinking, why am I not there? Why not to create that vision environment? Write it down, vision environment. Because a lot of people say, yeah, but you know what? I live in a communal space and I can't do this and I can't. My challenge to you is make it happen. Create the circumstance. If you're not able to put stuff around your home or your room or whatever it is, what about your purse? You can put something in there. Why don't you put your gold card in your purse? Why don't you put your gold card in your purse? Why don't you put your gold card in your car? Put it on the steering wheel or put it near the gear stick. Put it somewhere where you can see it. Put it somewhere where it's always in front of you. So going back to the original F word, the focus, what does that do? What does a goal card do? It recreates that focus all the time. It does not matter. And see, here's the thing. It does not matter if you miss a goal against a deadline. Like say if you've got a deadline and you're thinking, okay, I've set the goal, but I've not hit it, Mandy. I'm a failure. I can't do it. It doesn't matter. The goal does not change. The goal doesn't change. The time frame might change, but the goal does not change. If you set yourself to say, I'm going to be financially free this year, I'm going to leave my job, I'm going to sack the boss, I'm going to become independent, I'm going to learn to drive or buy a new house or car or whatever it is, do it. Is your environment conducive to your goal? I love the fridge idea. Yeah, 100%. Gold on your fridge. Put them everywhere. Literally put them everywhere. Outside your shower door, put it there. Because before you go into the shower, what are you looking at? You're looking at your goal. How many times, come on, level with me. How many times do you open your fridge a day? Because if you're like me, it's probably a lot. So every time you go in the fridge, you're going to see your goal. I'm not saying put your goal in the fridge. I'm saying put it on the door. Okay. What about those of you that have cereal? I don't know what everybody eats here, by the way. I have some no added sugar cereal, by the way. I'm quite proud of myself. But the key thing is that every time I'm opening the cupboard door, I'm seeing my goal. Because I'm in the morning, open the door, but I do that every day. So why not have my goal on the door? I just stuck it on there. I thought, yep. Wherever I look, wherever I'm seeing things or whatever I'm doing, I'm going to stick my goal there. So why not to print out your goal 15 times and stick it around your house? Doesn't matter what anybody else thinks or says. Because if that's your goal, if that's your destination, your house should look like your destination, not your past. A lot of people have pictures around their homes, which is great. From previous holidays they've been on, I used to do that. Where I've been, what I've seen, what I've done. But that's not my future. And a lot of these things I've learned from my mentors as well. They're saying, why do you have your past in your home, not your future? What, you know, you want X, Y, Z. So why not put pictures of the things around your home? Control your environment. Don't let your environment control you. This is the power of what we have, ladies. I hope you're understanding what I'm saying. We have a lot of power in us and we've got to use that to our advantage. So use it to your advantage. It doesn't matter what someone else is thinking, saying, or whatever it is. You control your environment, not the environment controls you. Now, this is a really, really big key thing that I believe every single one of us can start doing. Go tomorrow to the local superstore and print out 15 copies of your goal, but print it in picture form because the brain processes pictures a lot faster than words. We think in pictures. If I said to you, pink elephant, you're going to think of a pink elephant. You're not going to see the words pink elephant. You're going to think, oh, wow, okay, that's interesting. See, I could tell you anything right now and you will immediately think about it. Why? Because the brain processes information in pictures. So if you're going to give your brain something to think about, why not think about your goal? Why not think about your goal? Seriously, this stuff is so powerful. Okay, it's extremely powerful. I can't discuss too much about money goals on this call, because obviously I'd love to, but you know, this call is recorded and going on YouTube. We can't make any income claims or anything like that. But I made a certain goal this year. And halfway through the year, I hit that goal. And I was stunned. I was like, this is so early on. I set it for 2021, but I hit it really quickly. Why? Because everywhere, literally, and I went insane with this goal. I put it everywhere. I put it in the bathroom, on the shower, cupboard or fridge. It was in my purse. It was in my car, everywhere. And it was insane. And it really got me thinking, you know what? This stuff is powerful. And everything that all the great successful people talk about is this kind of stuff. It's about law of attraction. It's about, you know, write out your goal. It's about feel good now. So why not to do that? Why to waste our energy on the past where things didn't work? Why not to create a future where it matters and where we can own and create our own economy? So I'm giving you a solution right here, right now. Get to work. If you do not have a picture of your goal, after this call, go to Google, get the best picture that you like and print that out 15 times tomorrow. Not 16, not 5, not 10, 15. Do 15 and put it around your house. If you can't put it around your house, put it around your room. This stuff really works. Okay, this stuff really works. Next thing I wanted to talk about is, I mean, this is related to our environment massively, but your senses. The most powerful senses we have, obviously, we have 5 of them. But the two that I want to focus on today is sight and hearing. Sight and hearing. Sight and hearing. Why do I keep repeating that? My question to you is, what are you seeing every day? Sight. Whatever you see, you believe. Isn't it true? They say seeing is believing. So what are you feeding your senses? What are you feeding your eyes every day? We have the power of imagination that we can use on a daily basis. But if you're seeing your goal and you're feeling, like I'm looking at that goal right now in front of me, I'm thinking, this is good. I'm so excited about it. I'm so excited about it. And when it's done, I'm going to show you that goal, okay? Because it's right there and it's literally happening very, very soon. But what I want to ask you is, how do you feel when you see your goal? Is the feeling there when you see it in front of you? How does it feel? And what are you hearing? Now, there's 2 things connected here. Speaking is not a sense, but speaking impacts your sense of hearing. Whatever you're speaking, you're listening to. I always take the example of religion on this call. So, 100%. I read in the comments and the chat box, and some of them got private messages, which is amazing. But have a look at your goal. Have a look at your goal every single day. But like I was saying, religion. Some of us on this call are Christian. Some are Muslim. Some are Hindu, some are Buddhist, some are Sikh. I come from a Sikh background. Some people have no religion. They're not, they're atheist maybe. So we've got a collection of people on the call and you're from various different backgrounds. But why is it that you're a Muslim and I'm a Sikh? Why is it that someone might be a Christian and another person's Hindu? Why? It's because the way we were brought up, parents, taking us to church, mosque, temple, wherever it was. It's what we read as the holy books. It's where they took us every week. It's the pictures around the home that give us an indication, oh, this is a Christian person's home. This is a Muslim person's home. This is a Sikh person's home or Hindu, whatever it is. It's the way we were brought up in our environment. It makes a difference. The way our faith is developed, ladies, the way our faith is developed is how we create our faith towards our goals. Do you understand what I'm saying? This stuff is so powerful. If you really, truly understand this and take this seriously, it is life-changing information. You know, I've put this into practice a lot of times, and it's literally insane. It is literally insane. I'm telling you right now, it works. If you work and you understand and put what I'm saying into practice, printing out your goal, living in your future, feeling good, you are going to see some amazing, powerful results. Not just good, not just not so bad. They're going to be powerful to the point that they're going to make you really emotional because you're going to think, oh my God, she told me to print the goal 15 times and it's happening. Because I didn't believe it, by the way, when I first heard this, I thought, yeah, okay, it's fine. you know, more law of attraction stuff. And this is in the beginning days when I started my journey here, because I wasn't familiar with things like the law of attraction and energy and feeling good. But the more that I studied, ladies, the more that I studied and I got to grips with the information, the more I start to think, hang on, these people know a thing or two about success, and I want to be successful, and I will be successful. So I need to follow what they're telling me. And that's exactly what I did. So really be careful what you are saying every day. You got to speak your goal. I'm so happy and grateful that I look fantastic. I'm so happy and grateful that I've lost X amount of weight. Or maybe you don't want to use the word lost. Forget that. We're not going to include any negative language in the goals. You might want to say, I look at my best figure. I am at the weight of, I'm so happy and grateful, I'm at the weight of X amount. Why don't you put it that way? Positive language, remember, language is so important because it influences the way we feel and think. And, you know, whatever's coming out of this is going to influence this. So it's always got to be positive. And the purpose of these calls, one of my main purposes of doing calls like this, is to raise awareness, because I want every woman that I'm connected with to feel good here and here. Because I know if I can do that and I can impact people and women to feel good about themselves, that's half the battle done. Because I know when someone feels good, they're going to perform like a boss woman, because it's all about feeling. If you feel good, you look good. If you feel good, there is power around you. There are miracles around you. There's an insane amount of craziness that happens when your energy is at an all-time high. And I've seen it happen in my own life. I've seen it happen in my sibling's life. I've seen it happen in a lot of women's lives around me, because I know when they're at their best, it's like magic. It's literally like magic. When you see the craziness and the momentum around them, they are like new women. I've got so many examples of women that I've met. They started off in one place, you know, maybe a bit timid or shy or whatever. They didn't really believe in themselves, and they've come out and they're like, the wind's blowing in their hair. And, you know, they look great. They feel great. They're speaking great. Their confidence, oh my God, it is at an all-time high. And this is the purpose. My question to you is, going back to your goal, what is your goal? You've got 2 months left of the year. What are you going to do to further yourself towards that goal? So we've spoken about environment. We've spoken about people. We've spoken about senses, what you're hearing and what you're seeing. Now, my last thing to you, and this is something that, you know, sometimes we can struggle with, is self-image and self-talk. Let's have an honest conversation with each other. What is your level of self-image in terms of positivity, your level of self-talk and your self-image? What is it on a daily basis, 1 to 10? Do you batter yourself every day? So probably a 0 or 1. Or do you genuinely say good things to yourself? How do you speak to you? Because remember, you hang out with you more than anyone else. You hang out with you more than anyone else. Okay, put it in the chat box. I mean, let's hear from you, ladies. Okay, let's say, okay, wow. So we've got a -1. Fair enough. We've got 2. So what are you saying to yourself? Like, on a scale of 1 to 10, put it in the chat box. How do you talk to yourself? Is it good or not so good? Is it 0, 1, 2? Like, I don't think of myself as good, or is it that I genuinely feel good? Let's have a look at the responses. So we've got 2, I've got 5, I've got 9. Amazing. We've got 5, we've got 8, we've got 7. So to the ladies under 8, why are you not talking to yourself in a good way? Why are you battering yourself? Is it you or is it someone else? Who is around you? People check. Remember those 5 people that I told you about? They're going to influence your self-image and they're going to influence your self-talk. So you better make sure that you're around the right people. Pick up the phone to the person that is going to uplift you. If you're in a situation right now where you're not feeling good on a daily basis, you've got some personal stuff going on, your self-talk, your self-image is low, you need to raise that self-image. You need to start saying the best things to yourself. Let me put it another way. If your daughter, your sister, your mother was talking to herself or talking to you, what would you expect her to say to you? Is it that, well, you're not good enough and you can't do this and you suck? Like, it ain't going to happen. How would you feel? How would you feel if they, or even talking to a three-year-old, yeah, the three-year-old you, would you say that to the three-year-old you? Why are you saying it to yourself now? Why are you telling yourself you're not good enough when you are the best, when you're amazing? Start changing the language, ladies. Self-image, self-talk. The way you see yourself is the way the world sees you. The way you see yourself is the way the world is going to see you. So who are you? What is your portrayal of yourself on a call, on social media, on the phone, around your friends? Maybe you're someone that wants to get out of their comfort zone. What's stopping you? Come out the comfort zone. Come out, come out, come out. In order to get to our goals, ladies, self-talk, self-image, senses, our hearing and sight, environment and people are going to be so important towards helping us to make the best of us. This call was all to do with focus, focus, focus. And each one of these things that I wrote down when I was looking at what I'm going to talk about today, it all requires a level of self-focus. A lot, sometimes a lot more than others times, but it definitely works. And I want us all to make a commitment to each other that we're going to help one another to be the best of us. Because some of you might be, you know, around great people. You're around the best people, whether it's your husband or your partner, or, you know, your family, your children, your siblings, and you're in the best possible family and environment, but your self-talk is negative. Your self-image is low. That's not conducive. It can't be really high in one place and then really low right here. It's got to be consistent on all planes. This is why you can even do a wheel if you want. We're always good at doing the wheel of life, the wheel of balance. Write down on that wheel self-talk, self-image, environment, senses, people. You make a circle and cross on there where on a level of 1 to 10 is your self-image. The five people, are they the positive or not so positive? Put it in a wheel form and see what you come up with. Because if the wheel is all squidgy and not so great, you know the area that you need to work on. Because any one of these four areas is going to impact the woman that you are today. The way you thought of yourself, let me put it this way. The way you thought of yourself last week will impact this week. What you say to yourself today is going to impact your tomorrow. What you say to yourself and believe, these next few months is going to impact your 2022. So I'm going to leave it there and say, look, are you believing, seeing, and speaking the right things? Are you around the right people? Are you the power woman, the best that you can be, or have your current circumstances got you down? I'm here to say, ladies, wake up. Wake up and start being the best of you. Maybe you could be the one who's running the Women Empowerment Show in the next few weeks. And I'm sitting down taking the notes. You know, I'm sitting down, I had to take some notes this week. But really think about what I said. Make your environment conducive to you. Print out your goal 15 times. Look at your self-image. Write down who you are and what you want to see in you. Not your husband, not your dad, not your brother, your sister, or anyone else. It's what you think of you, because your portrayal of you, your self-talk, your self-image is going to impact the world. And it's got to be your best. It's got to be your best self. What about your senses? What are you hearing and seeing every day? Again, if I go into your home today, what do I see? Your past or your future? Your past or your future? So ladies, we have something, we have a gift, we have something in us that can help so many of the women out there, to empower them, to strengthen them, to help their faith, to be the best of them. So why not you? My question to you is, are you going to be the next woman, the next lady boss, who's going to really help to impact the world and make it a better place? So on that note, I want to say many, many thanks for listening. I really, really enjoyed that conversation with you all tonight. I will be posting this to YouTube. But once again, thank you so much for your time. Appreciate it. And I'll see you in 2 weeks' time. Thank you.